Hey guys, it's Jeff Gelman, Sally K&I Training. I'm really excited to share this video. You're gonna see one of our trainers, Julia, working with his dog, Blue. It's just learning the down command. We already put the video up, but I really wanna talk about this dog. It's a typical dog that comes in here. So this is about a 150 pound dog, and they told us it was a Great Dane, but I think that we're gonna have, there's probably some Corso in there. There's definitely some Corso in there. Pulls them like a freight train. This dog literally pulls them around. Imagine a 150 pound dog pulling you wherever it wants to go, has no respect for the handler whatsoever, drags them all over the place. It's bitten a human before. So the dog came in 2 days ago, 3 days ago now. The video that you're gonna see attached to this video is from Julia working this dog from 2 days ago. And when you get a dog like that that comes in, you know it's pretty interesting. Their life is pretty small. Their life is pretty small with a dog like this. They can't take this dog anywhere. They can't take it off their property. They can't take it for walks. They can't have people over their house. They're really, really limited on what they can do. So what you're gonna see is on day one, we did a couple of drills with the dog to get the dog to stop all of the nonsense. And those drills are just pretty much a bunch of quick 180s back and forth. It's like the dog wants to rush out of its kennel. It wants to pull. So what do you need to do is you're gonna catch the dog prior to before you get to the end of the leash, make a directional change. You go the other way, you do it again, you do it again, you do it again, and finally the dog just goes, I guess I'm just supposed to stay next to you. I mean, you can't work a dog like that. You can't work a dog that's like, wants to just run everywhere. And then once you get a dog to start understanding that it can't do that, now you've got a dog that just goes, okay, so I'm hanging out, what do we do? Bingo. Now let's start training. And that's when my staff just starts training. So you'll see the beginning stages of, we use food for all the obedience work that we do. So you'll start seeing that. You'll see Julia, one of our trainers, working that dog. Just really, really excited. You know, 2-3 days in, we're getting now a dog that can be walked around the training center. It actually walks behind the staff. After the first week of all the baseline stuff, after we teach this dog all these skills, what we'll do is we will take the dog off property, because shit gets real when you go off property, when there's like other dogs and other people. Now, we've got a lot of dogs in the training center here. It's probably seen about 35 dogs, because it could be a daycare dog, it could be one of our personal dogs, it could be one of the board and train dogs. So it's getting a lot of dog exposure. This dog has no dog exposure. They've owned the dog for a year, and the dog was a year old when they got it, so it's a 2-year-old dog. But super proud of the staff. They're doing a really, really great job. And again, typical dog. You know, and when you see a dog like this coming in like a freight train, it makes you think about, there's not too many people that would work with a dog like this. People just don't know what to do with dogs like this. They don't know what to do with these. They don't know what to do with lunging dogs in general, let alone one this size. So this dog would probably be deemed untrainable by a lot of people. This dog would be deemed to be put to death by a lot of people because it has a bite history to it. But you're gonna see over the next X amount of weeks, I think this is a 6-weeker, Joelle. This is a 6-weeker. You're gonna see over the next 6 weeks, an incredible transformation. Incredible transformation. And then the cool part is that at the 3-week mark, the owner's coming in for training. So remember when you watch this video, which Joelle will splice into here, how that dog came in. They weren't sure they were going to get this dog out of the car. Like, they didn't even know how to get in here. And you're going to see the owner of this dog walk this dog calmly. It's going to be pretty, pretty exciting. So we're really excited for that. But that's just one of the many success stories we really have here. So that's really exciting. You know, one of the things that folks, you know, should realize, and I think, you know, a lot of our fans do, but if you're brand new to our page, we've been getting a lot of really new followers, so thank you all so much. We specialize in aggression rehabilitation, and we're more of a rehabilitation center. We also obedience train the dogs. I mean, the dogs need to understand sit, down, place, recall, and also we want to work on duration, and we work on state of mind. So a lot of the times when you see these dogs, say, lying down on a mat, so imagine this dog, Blue, lying down on a mat, and a lot of people might say, geez, you look sort of bored. go back to the initial video of him coming in, okay? That was him not bored. So let's say he is bored. He's not bored. He's calm. There's a big difference. So we do work with a lot of state of mind, because as a family pet dog trainer, I know when my dogs are in my house, I want them to be calm. I know when I'm at an outdoor cafe, I want them to be calm. And I think that, you know, we're a huge advocate of exercise, but there's a time for exercise. Most dogs don't need help exercising more. What the families need is they need help getting their dogs to be calmer more. And even the most highest drive dog can be calm, on command, by the way, without being tired. All right, Jeff Gelman, Solid Canine Training, madly in love with you, blessed and honored that you're on the page watching our videos. Thank you so much.
Tell me a little bit about why you're here and like how your life has been with him.
We haven't had one since we got him. We tried to introduce him to Pete's son, who's was 20 at the time, and he did not take to him. Ended up biting him on the arm, and then that was pretty much the last time he came over. So no one comes to the house. We can't like go camping or do any of that stuff with him. So. We just stay home. He's pulled me down a few times. He smelled something as we were getting close to the house, and I had him on because he chewed through the leash I had, so I had him on one of those 30-foot run leashes, but I created handles in it. But he pulled it so hard, he ended up slicing my finger, because I don't know what he was going after. He just smelled something that he wanted, I guess.
Good. Good boy. Good job. Good. 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 Good.